So data visualization, it's a big topic. I'm only going to scratch the surface. So data visualization, I see it as falling under two categories. We've got discovery of patterns, but also effective communication. They're both important. I'm going to cover both. I mean, the way to think about it when you're in terms of both the patterns and the communication, I guess more the communication is you're trying to tell a story with the data. You're trying to make a point. And I'm going to start with this plot. You see along the y-axis here, we have weight in pounds and then the date going back from 2012 all the way to 2016. So what is this? This is actually my weight over time. And you see there's these weird fluctuations. So these fluctuations need some explanation. I got into biking to work. There's me. That's an action shot, biking to work. I live about 8 miles away from where I work. That was pretty dangerous right there. I hope nothing bad happened. I've added on the right side miles cycled per day. So you can see the scale goes up to about 30, but the most that I did was I started out going about 12 and then went up to about 17 miles a day. And that's when I have these episodes when I would bike a lot. So in 2013, I was actually on sabbatical in Spain and I biked to work. So my weight went down and then I did nothing, lived my usual sedentary life. And then kind of mid-August, I decided I'm going to ride my bike again. And then I was kind of sporadic and you could see my weight just climbs back up. It kind of shot down because I was probably biking to work every day for a stretch there. And then I just sort of hit some kind of maintenance weight. So there we go. So this data tells a story partly because of how I presented it. I chose the scale here for the weight in pounds so that it only went from like 150 to 175. I didn't go from zero to whatever. I didn't use some default. Often you don't want to use default. Showing some bar charts here. And maybe you're looking at bar charts. This is a default thing. If you've ever used Excel, people will give bar charts. And this is very jarring. It's not clear what the message is. This is just a sort of generic presentation. But it looks like it's trying to show different regions and different times and percent of progress. What if we pulled this out and put it in a different way? Maybe it's better written as a bunch of time series. So here's some overlapping time series with some colors, but again, they're all sort of huddled in one little part of the graph. It's hard to really tease out what's going on. It might make sense for a situation like this to just do the time series, but separate them out. So do multiples of the same type of plot and kind of give every, in this case, region its day in the sun. And then maybe from this, you could see some patterns, or if you're presenting, you could say, oh, look, region C seems to be ever increasing and we need to put some more resources there. Let me show another kind of confusing plot. This is some real data. The percent of students meeting reading score targets has steadily risen. It looks like there's some years, 2006 to 2012, and then some different grades, 9th to 12th grade. But some people will see something like this and their mind will just turn off. It's hard to take in a lot of information like this. And this isn't tons of information. It's just a few graphs over time. But you can use a little trick. I teach my students to do this for giving presentations. One of the nice things to do is you just sort of clean the canvas. You can set the stage with, I've got years along the bottom, percent of our students meeting the reading along the top. And let me start with the 9th graders. And then we can go on and on talking about the 9th graders and why we see this. As it is, how do we explain that little dip? And then we could talk about the 10th graders. So we're just sort of building up a complicated plot step by step. All it took was starting with the final plot and then maybe erasing, but then showing it in reverse order. Let me give you some more tips. Customizing plots. I think you should, in general, not use the defaults. It looks bad and could be misleading. I'll give you some examples. What do I mean by defaults? If you plot something, say in MATLAB, you'll get a plot that looks like this. So maybe this is plotting two different curves. I see some kind of x-axis, I see a y-axis, but it would be a lot better if I change things, like put the min and max along the y-axis, label some of the curves, fill some of them in, make some of them wider than others, even put in a legend. If you just turn in the default, it isn't exactly clear what's being described. Here, at least we have some context. Okay, there's something called chi and we're plotting it, some kind of chi-squared dependence. You really want to customize things, especially when giving presentations. All right, I'd like to know what your thoughts are. just any questions or any comments.
Please share your thoughts in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. I've got extra information and the links in the description.